took office, President Obama has made it clear that he inherited an economic mess from his predecessor. But he's not the first president to face an economic crisis on day one of his presidency. Ronald Reagan walked into the Oval Office with much higher gas prices and a similar unemployment rate, but he managed to turn things around, some would say, more quickly. So here to remind us of exactly how much Reagan inherited is presidential historian Nick Ragone. Nick, thanks for waking up early with us.
Good to be with you, Allison.
Okay, let's take a look at the comparison between President Reagan and President Obama. Particularly, let's start with unemployment, because obviously that is the thing that has bedeviled President Obama so much. Their rates were very similar on the month that they took office, 7.5 for Ronald Reagan and 7.6 for Barack Obama. Now, something interesting happens to both of these men a year into their presidencies, and that is that unemployment spikes. It goes up to about 9.8 for President Obama, and it goes up to, if you can believe it, 10.8 for President Reagan. But President Reagan was able to incrementally bring that number down every quarter in a way that President Obama hasn't been able to. What was the difference in strategy?
Well, you're right. They came in with very similar numbers. By 81, though, Ronald Reagan passed tax reform. He lowered the top rate from 70% to 50%. He cut business taxes, the estate tax. And by re-election time, it was down into the fives, and it consistently got lower through his 8 years in office. And we had the largest post-war expansion from, I think, about 83 to 89. With President Obama, he came in, and we had the stimulus package, which was about $800 billion. We haven't seen as much growth. There's been sort of marginal growth. The unemployment rate almost peaked near 10%, as you mentioned. It's back down to about 83.3%. We'll see where it goes now. But Reagan certainly had 5 years of great expansion that brought that rate down to historic lows.
But it is fascinating to hear you talk about the highest tax rate for the highest income earners, because obviously that is so timely. That's something that President Obama talks about all the time. And it's important to remember how high it was under Reagan, but then he brought it down.
Yeah, it's amazing to think about. It wasn't that long ago, 30 years ago, you know, that 70% was the top marginal rate, and it getting down to 50% was considered a huge tax cut. Now, again, in 86, if you remember, Reagan passed the historic tax reform that got it to the rates that we see now and made it actually much flatter, lower, I think 28 and 15%. But it's hard to imagine a rate that high. And now we're talking about the Bush tax cuts being sunsetted. So in theory, we could actually have a tax increase on the top marginal rates if the Bush tax cuts go away, which may have an impact on job growth as well.
Right, of course, and the Buffett rule that the president talks about so much. Let's talk about another thing in the news and that is so timely, gas prices. President Reagan, when he took office, the average price for a gallon of gas was $3.13. These have been adjusted for inflation. President Obama, the day he took office, $1.95. Those are pretty incredible numbers also, and to see what's happened since.
Yeah, it's remarkable. Of course, it's adjusted for inflation, but when Reagan took over, we had the oil shock of the late 70s, and gas in real dollars back then was $1.25, which factored out is a 3-plus now. When President Obama came in, gas actually took a little bit of a dip because the economy was in such a recession. What happens is gas prices typically come down during recessions. So adjusted, it was much cheaper. Now, we know this summer they're going to go back up again as the economy picks up a little steam. But it's important to keep in mind that gas was a huge, for those of us that remember, a huge issue in the late 70s and early 80s, worse than it is now, which is almost hard to believe, but it really was.
And what was President Reagan able to do about that?
Well, I think gas is one of those things that it's countercyclical. It's hard for presidents to have total control, but I think his energy policy was a bit more aggressive in trying to find oil production and make it easier for companies to explore oil here. And I know that's part of the debate now with the Keystone Pipeline is how do we access our own energy and have a more energy independent policy. So we'll see where that goes.
All right, Nick Ragone, you're a presidential historian. Thanks so much for giving us context. Clayton Morris is very jealous that I got this segment today. Thanks so much.